Well, some fed-up viewers turn to two when a neighborhood eyesore begins to threaten their safety.
Tonight, they're asking the city to tear it down. The house in question is in the 100 block of Deeds Avenue on Old North Dayton.
Jordan Burgess live to tell us what is being done about it and the many others just like it. Jordan?
Imagine moving into a new home only to have a fire at the house next door on your first night. That's the case for one family we talked with, and since then they've had to live with the damage, but help could be on the way. This house has seemingly defied the laws of gravity and the efforts of neighbors to remain standing.
We just thought that the process would end up with it being torn down eventually, but you know, eventually is a year later.
That's right. For more than a year, the people living here on Deeds Avenue have had to wake up next to this each day. One neighbor put up these boards to keep the wall from collapsing onto his house. On the other side, John Tevis and his family have to keep their windows closed. And then there's the kids who see these piles of debris as a playground.
There's pits over there where it falls straight down into the basement. One of the kids can get over there and fall right down in the basement.
We called city officials to ask them about the holdup in taking down this house. Just recently, the city announced it will use an extra $1 million from the budget to take down fire-damaged homes. But because that has to go through the bid process, officials say the teardowns won't happen until early 2012. And even then, the money will only cover about half of the roughly 120 fire-damaged homes in the city. So some will be left out.
I think this should be the first one that they tear down when they get to that list.
And city officials say when it comes to deciding which homes to take down, they'll look at safety issues and at which ones are causing the most problems for police and firefighters. And of course, we'll continue to keep an eye on the progress over the coming months. Reporting live, Jordan Burgess, 2 News on your side.